Okay, so I've been thinking about making this video for a while, and it's about Sting. You guys know that I'm a huge fan of Sting as a writer in The Police. And one of the reasons I'm a fan of him is because I think that Sting is uncopyable. There is something about the way that he writes that no one has ever been able to copy in any way. You can't crack the Sting code, really, for some reason. And it has to do with the way that he writes melodies, the rhythms, the note choices, how he uses modes. I've done videos where I use his songs to demonstrate particular things, like, for example, in a video I did on the Aeolian mode, which you can see here, I'm talking about the song I Burn For You, which is a perfect example of Aeolian. Check it out.
Now that I have found you,
beautiful.
And the cool
That's flat six. Keeps going back to it.
Well, the shade of your parasol and your love flows through me.
When I did my video on Dorian, the first thing I thought was like, let's see, is there a good example of Sting using Dorian? Yeah, there's about 10 examples of it. Sting writes in modes, and Sting knows exactly what he's doing. In my Joni Mitchell video on Amelia, I played a snippet of an interview where Joni is talking about sus chords. Well, Sting is the person that really, out of anyone that I can think of that is a huge pop songwriter, one of the greatest songwriters of all time, and actually knows the purpose of every note, what scale it comes from, how the notes work against the chord, how to create grooves that imply certain modes. And I want to give you some examples of these in this video. The first song I want to talk about is called Fortress Around Your Heart, one of the most complex pop songs ever. It was the first single off Dream of the Blue Turtles, which came out in 1985. It was his first solo record. They made a movie called Bring On the Night about it, and the players in the band, Omar Hakim was playing drums, Cyril Jones on the bass, Kenny Kirkland on the keyboards, Branford Marsalis on saxophone, and Sting played guitar. And this particular song has one of the most unique guitar riffs and changes keys three times before it goes in the chorus. Let me play you the beginning of it so you can check it out. Okay, so this riff here is over a bass line. G Dorian. Listen. That's an incredibly cool riff. D sus, C5, okay, C5 power chord, and then to B flat, major 9, no third. But this is all over a G bass note. So these notes are all from G Dorian. And if you think of G Dorian, there's the scale. So those are the notes that Sting's using to create his melody here in the verse.
No flies of truce, no cries of pity.
There's a ninth there. But now we're going to modulate to E flat. And then modulate again, down a half step to F sharp Dorian. Let's talk about the key change there for a second. It's really interesting. So we're going from G Dorian down to E flat Mixolydian. And I call it E flat Mixolydian because it's bouncing back and forth between an E flat 7 chord and an A flat major. So E flat 7, right? 5, 1. So this is E flat 7, A flat major, E flat 7, A flat major, right? And then the melody right here. So he's going. If you think about this, there's your E flat Mixolydian.
It took a day to build a city.
Really sophisticated melody with all those intervals. And then.
We walk through the streets in the afternoon.
So that melody right there.
We walk through the streets in the afternoon.
Really great outlining that E-flat dominant sound, that E-flat Mixolydian sound. And then it modulates down to F-sharp minor, F-sharp Dorian, which is a half step below G Dorian that we just started the verse with right here. The reason I say that's F-sharp Dorian is because it's really clearly spelling out this F-sharp minor 13 sound. Here's F-sharp Dorian, right? That note there, that D-sharp, is giving you that F-sharp Dorian sound. It's very, very clear because the bass line is vamping around F-sharp. It's not moving around to other chords. And you can hear him right there. All these huge skips down a sixth, up a fourth, things like that. And then he sets up this B dominant to go to the chorus here. And he hits this A, which is the seventh of the B7 chord. So he's going, of walking on the lines of Lady F. It's just incredibly great. Right up that Mixolydian. He skips one note. And ends on that, the seventh of the B, and then launches right into the chorus. If I built this fortress around your heart. And the chorus melody, once again, is just a masterful puzzle of outlining the chords on the E minor. The D major chord over F sharp. Down to the fifth of the G. To the third of A minor. And then here's the fifth of the D chord. It's going back and forth between C and D. So you have E minor, D over F sharp, G, A minor, and then C, C major to D major. The next thing that happens is the transition from the chorus back to the verse to the G Dorian vamp. Check this out. I love this chord progression. Right here. So he's going from really A flat over C, right? First inversion, A flat major chord, B flat over D, E flat sus2, F sus2, and then to the back into that vamp. It's so seamless. The flow of it is amazing. Here we go. Genius. The next song I want to talk about is off the Police's last record, Synchronicity. The song is Synchronicity 2, and it was a single off that record. And once again, it is so sophisticated musically that it doesn't sound like anything else. I want to talk about the chord progression and how weird it is. Let's check it out from the top. It starts out in this F sharp minor 11 chord. With a lot of feedback. This is where the bridge to Money for Nothing comes from this song. It's actually Sting singing on that tune, this melody. So it's F sharp minor 11. And then it goes into the verse right here. It goes from this F sharp Dorian sound, right? Then G to D, and then the verse is an A. So it's A to A over C sharp, but then it jumps from this down to G, right? So you have that weird tritone move. Then so G to D, and then back to A. That's not even the weird part. Every new section goes to a completely different place. Right here. So this is an A pedal section. It's going A, D over A, B7 over A, back to D over A. Listen. Then it goes to D minor, and it's really over this D chord, the D minor 7 to D minor 6. So we've just come from this A pedal section, which is changing keys, and then to D minor, D Dorian, really. And then he hits the low E. So he's using this D over E to E, which is really like E mixolydian. Probably all thinking, why is Rick always talking about modes? Because there's really no other way to explain it when you have these pedals, right? Because you're really, this is modal writing. When you have a chord, a bass note that stays static, and you have these other chords over there. Yeah, you can say that's just the fifth and the bass there, right? But this, that B7 over A, well, that is not in the key, so you've changed keys there. And then to go to that, the D minor there, is way out in left field, but the melody is so strong that it sounds completely normal. There we go. So you have this A sus2, F major over A, and then G7 to D minor over F, and then E major to F major over E, and then he goes, then back into the verse. That is so out there, yet it sounds completely normal, and that was a single. And it sounds normal because the melody is so strong on it. But think about how many different times. We start on this F sharp minor. And then. Right. And then you have the second section. Then third section. Then you have. That is so sophisticated, but Sting's sense of melody is so strong that you just discount that. You don't even think about that it's changing keys and completely out there weird. It's so melodic. The melody is so strong, it just carries it. Let me give you one more example of the brilliance of Sting and the Police. And it's in the song Synchronicity. And it goes from F minor to a really surprising place. Check this out. Pedaling on F. Okay, so it's going from F Dorian. It's using the ninth in there. There's a lot of clusters in the vocals, but then. Incredible to go from F minor to A minor like that, going from that Dorian sound of F to the Dorian sound of A. I just have never heard it in another song before. And these were just common things that Sting, they weren't common. I mean, Sting came up with these things, but they were just genius. Absolutely genius. There's so many examples. I could talk about the bridge of Every Breath You Take, because that is a beautiful modulation there. Unexpected, but this is why Sting, to me, is uncopyable. Nobody can really copy his sense of melody and the way that he puts these chord progressions together. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're a first-time viewer, don't forget to ring the bell. Also, don't forget to like and comment on the video. I never say that, but that actually helps the videos do better. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. It's got all these kind of concepts in there. That's how I support my channel. Follow me on Instagram at rickbeato1. Check out my new Beato Ear Training program. Go to beatoeartraining.com and watch the intro video. And if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching.